Coming up Christmas, the 26th, Sunday the 26th, Seattle Center Arena, a tag team cage match. Hacksaw Sawyer and Billy Jack against Rib Oliver and the Sheik. Hacksaw.
You know, Mr. Savage, everybody in Seattle seen what happened the last time I was there with the Sheik and Rip Oliver. You know, I had the Sheik in Iranian death match. I had him beat. Oliver grabbed my feet. Everybody in that Coliseum seen it. Then the Sheik got on me. One, two, three. Billy Jack, I picked as a partner to get my revenge on the Sheik. He got his match, an Iranian death match. Great. You had your match. That's water under the bridge. You know, now I got Billy Jack in a cage match. A 10-foot cage match. Nobody's going to get out of it. And believe me, you me, brother, here's the size and here's the speed. And there ain't no other companion you can beat that with.
This is the type of match that end all matches. That's why you keep both your opponents in the ring. You keep any interference from outside or inside. And Billy, this is the first time you've ever been involved in one of these. You've got two really rotten opponents there in the Sheik and Rip Oliver.
Rip Oliver, I know you're listening out there in the monitor, brother. We're 100% business all the way. What you did the other day, you pulled a Hacksaw's leg out. That's the only way you want it. Now it's two against two in a cage. There's no way out, brother. And Sheik, you're going back to Iran because I'm doggone proud to be an American, brother. You're going to go back in a box one way or another, brother. I ain't kidding you one bit. We mean business.
Okay, thanks, gentlemen. We got a little irate the last time we were up there down in Seattle, and somebody called us a few names, we Americans, and we Americans called a few people a few names on that particular night, and for our colloquialisms, we apologize. We lost our temper. The Sheik said a few nasty things about the fans in Seattle and myself and knocking my heritage, and I, in no uncertain terms, let him know what I thought of that.
Well, I heard that things got a little out of hand up there. Okay.
I have to apologize to Oliver and the Sheik. I didn't mean to say that they were rotten, as per se, rotten. Their tactics are unbelievable. I'll put it that way. How's that?
In other words, it wasn't anything personal.
Okay.
We're going to get ready for the main event tonight. A tag team match.
Billy, I think we've got about 25-minute time limit here. I'm not sure how much time we've got left for the TV main event. But it will be a tag team bout, and we're looking forward to the combatants coming out now.
And those combatants are going to be in the form of Billy Jack and Stan Stasiak teaming up against Rip Oliver, Ripper the Crippler and the Assassin.
This match, incidentally, is for the Pacific Coast Championship. The belt was held up here between these four individuals. The championship is at stake tonight. It is at stake. But the belt does not belong to Rip Oliver or the Assassin, and it does not belong to Stan Stasiak or Billy Jack. The belt was held up by the commission. It is in limbo. However, the belt is on the line in this television bout, and you're going to get a chance to see it.
Okay. Well, this is it for the belt tonight, this afternoon. There's the Assassin and Rip Oliver in the ring right now. And here comes Stan the Man, Stasiak, and Billy Jack. Well, I tell you, there's the guys taking the Northwest by storm. The Northwest owned Billy Jack. People love him. And here's Don Owen.
Ladies and gentlemen, the final match will be the best two out of three falls or to a TV time limit. Now, the belts were held up last Tuesday night at a wild bout, and so neither team will be recognized as the Northwest team champion. And whoever wins this tonight will be definitely the Northwest team champion. At this time, I would like to introduce in this corner the team of Rip Oliver and the Assassin. Their opponents in this corner, the team of Stan Stasiak and Billy Jack.
Well, there's no bout to doubt it who the favorites are here tonight, are there? Is there? Weren't there?
Am there? No doubt at all, Dutch.
Don Owens looking rather dapper tonight in his brown suede sport coat. Off brown tie.
That's your partner.
That's him.
Well, this should be a dandy. Don't go away. Call some friends. Tell them to tune in and catch this one.
Well, we got loads of people wanting to come in here now. Ron Ritchie from out Buffalo, New York, way, and Dean Ho is going to be coming down to see us. And also, this fellow Buddy Roberts is down in Houston, Texas, in Dallas now, right now. Oh, what an animal he is.
What'd you say his middle name is?
Is it Buddy H. Roberts? The middle initial stands for hate or hatred. Oh, I don't know. This guy is really something. He's a real animal. Buddy Roberts. We'll be seeing him in the Northwest here very shortly. Buddy Rose is coming back. Buddy sent word that he's coming back in the Pacific Northwest to give the people a chance to look at a real big star.
Yeah.
Must mean that he picked up about 80 pounds.
Yeah, that may be what it means.
But he's doing real well. He went up for the World Heavyweight Championship in New York, set attendance records back there. The house was something like $230,000 in Madison Square Garden. But he's coming back. He'll be coming back with a flair. You can assure yourselves of that.
Well, I'll tell you, talk about...
There's a go behind and a takedown by Stan Stasiak.
Talk about giving the devil his dues, Dutch. The man is drawing back there $230,000. That's...
Right. Right, I suppose if Seattle had 11 million people in it, we'd be drawing something like $1 million a gate. Because our fans are more loyal out here than they are back east. And you have to understand, our people go from here back there and they draw phenomenal houses. You don't see any of those guys coming from there out here because they can't cut the mustard.
There you go.
In case you just tuned in, you're a little late this afternoon. We're in the main event already. The assassin hanging on the ropes there in the black tights, the black outfit with the yellow mask. His partner, Rip Oliver, the blonde-headed guy, being held down by Stan Stasiak. That's the crusher, pushing him in the ropes right now. The guy on the outside holding on to the ring rope is Big Billy Jack.
Now this one is for the Northwest Tag Team Championship. This one's for the belt. That's Rip Oliver delivering a few shots to Stasiak's back, kicking him right out of the ring.
Ripper the Crippler Oliver. He gets a chance, he'll bust you up, but good. As long as you've got flesh on your bones and you're in the ring, you're fair game for that man.
Well, he has been known to send a few people packing with a whole lot of hurts. Uh-oh.
Oliver on the second rope. Double forearm right across the back of Stasiak. Take a good look at Oliver. You'll see none of his body weight is fat.
Well, Stan was trying to make his way over to make the tag with Billy Jack, but now the assassin and Oliver have got him pretty well in their own corner. There's the assassin delivering right-hand shots to the midsection of the chest of Stasiak. The assassin has been... knee to Stasiak's midsection.
There's 18 minutes remaining in this bout, I think. 18 minutes, according to the
Oliver's got it. He's got a hold of Stan's trunk, sir.
Double team him in the corner. Oh, there's a hard right hand by Stasiak. Another one on Oliver. Stan trying to get out of that corner. Trying to get out. Watch out.
Come on. Look at all red.
Yeah, you're going to say the same thing I would. Look at all the red marks on Stasiak's back.
The beating he's taking out there. Boy, he's really taking one. Oh, right in the throat. Makes the tag with the assassin. Oh my word.
Well, that was a clothesline. Yeah, that was a legal tag, too. The assassin tagged
going
in.
With the pin. He's
first
got it.
Ball.
He's got it. The first fall in this championship bout goes to Rip Oliver and the Assassin over Billy Jack and Stan Stasiak. And we'll be right back with more action after this timeout.
Hi, I'm Bobby at First Money. Buying a home? Need to refinance or second mortgage your home or investment properties? Need to borrow money for your business or to start a new business? Then call First Money Investment Corporation at 433-1797. We'll quote you current market rates, 24 hours a day. So, if you need a residential or commercial loan, we're just as close as your phone. Just call First Money at 433-1797.
Thunder Tube. The Snowcat Thunder Tube is spinning, sliding, family fun. Thunder Tube is rough and tough for lots of thrills. Inflatable Thunder Tube gives you real downhill action. The raised center seat makes you feel like you're riding on air. Hold on to the handles and away you go. Race, bump, and bounce on the Snowcat Thunder Tube. Thunder Tube. When you're looking for winter excitement, look to Snowcat products from Castle Rock.
In this incredible age of awesome technology, mankind still searches for solutions to the appalling evils that fill his world. What will it take to resolve this paradox? From the pages of the Bible, Herbert W. Armstrong on the World Tomorrow program shows the solution mankind has ignored. Watch The World Tomorrow.
The World Tomorrow is seen Sunday, 9:30 a.m. on KCPQ Q13.
This holiday season, plant a little happiness on someone's face. Through your growing gift to Operation Smile, you can help bring the spirit of the holidays into the rooms and hearts of nursing home residents. Bring a holiday plant and a signed card to the Downtown Seattle Athletic Club, located at the north end of the Pike Place Market. Your growing gift will be delivered to nursing home residents on December 24th. Give to Operation Smile today and grow a little happiness in someone's life. Sponsored by the Mayor's Office for Senior Citizens.
The handsome young gentleman you're looking at right now is none other than Ron Ritchie from Buffalo, New York. 6 foot, 230 pounds of him. You'll be seeing him here in the Pacific Northwest, and he'll be wrestling the likes of this gentleman standing next to me, the Assassin.
Let me tell you something, that savage, baby, Rip Oliver, he said, you know, Assassin, he said, we got to start doing things hard and nasty in the right way. So what you just seen here tonight was what I call and Oliver called a clan line, and I landed right up on Stasiak's neck, and you still see him over there right now with his head hanging a little bit shorter than it used to be. You understand where I'm coming from? So from now on, the clan, no matter where it's at, no matter where we've been, that's what you're going to see from now on. From Rip Oliver, Sheik Abdullah, and the Assassin, the three greatest professional wrestlers in the world, without a doubt in my mind, baby. When you see it, you're all gone.
Well, you heard it here. That was the Assassin, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be going to be going back to the ring for the next fall, the second fall of the evening, and back to my partner, Don Kahn.
Second fall, best two out of three, the championship match for the Northwest Tag Team Championship. And in the ring right now, Stan Stasiak and Billy Jack. Lost the first fall. Awaiting the arrival of Rip Oliver and the man you just heard from and saw, the Assassin. Well, I tell you, there's a lot of exciting professional wrestling action going on throughout the Northwest. Coming into the Northwest on the 26th at Seattle Center Arena, that tag team cage match, Billy Jack and Hacksaw Sawyer teaming up to go against Rip Oliver and the Sheik.
Well, I can't wait to see that one. You imagine that, Billy Jack. That's Billy Jack facing you, folks, holding on the ropes over there. And that's the Assassin starting to pummel Stasiak. Stasiak's had enough of it. And come on.
Oh, rake across the face.
Sucking him right back over to the corner. Oliver saying, I'm not going to touch him.
Yeah.
You believe that, don't you?
Sure.
Elbow.
Well, he touched him right there with an elbow on the back. Stan's trying to make it over to make the tag. Billy Jack.
Oliver's got him hooked in a front face lock. Billy Jack's about 2 foot away from Billy Jack.
A And Oliver doesn't want any part of Billy Jack either. Now Stan's delivering a couple of shots.
They got about 14 minutes remaining in this TV main event. Excuse me, Don. If you just joined us, the Assassin and Rip Oliver took the first fall. We're into the second fall right now. Oh, almost made the tag. Assassin intercepted Stasiak along the ropes.
Couldn't quite get over. It was close. The Assassin going back to work now on Stasiak. Forearm to the back. Boy, I tell you, they've really worked over his back. You can see how red it is from here. Stan coming back with a right-hand shot of his own, right to the top of the head. There's a boot in the midsection. Stasiak trying to crawl over and make the tag, and the Assassin takes a shot at Billy Jack. The Assassin makes the tag with Oliver. Oh, more punishment. Stasiak's back. Another knee. Oliver bearing down now on Stasiak. Got him around the neck, around the throat area. Stan's got his hand out there trying to make the tag with Billy Jack. But Oliver's not about to let him over there. There's a good shot to the midsection by Stasiak. Now he delivers a boot. And a beautiful right-hand shot right on the top of Oliver's head. Stan trying to get to his feet. Crawling over, trying to make the tag on Billy Jack. Not quite. Oliver doesn't want Billy Jack in there. Illegal shot right to Stasiak's jaw. Stasiak coming back with a couple of shots of his own. And a boot. And a fist. Look at this. He makes a tag with Billy Jack. Here comes Billy Jack. Paul Nelson. Paul Nelson on the Assassin. That's going to do it. That is going to do it.
This bout's all even.
That's it.
You don't get out of that, Paul Nelson. All right. Don't go away, ladies and gentlemen. This bout is all even. There's more to come, and we're going to have an interview with the Sheik right about now, as soon as I can get up out of here.
Oh, there is no way that anybody's going to get out of the hole with that Paul Nelson when it's applied by Billy Jack. And Billy Jack and Stan Stasiak win the second fall. And our match, our championship match now is all even at one fall apiece. Don't you dare go away. We're going over to Dutch Savage right now.
Okay, Don, ladies and gentlemen, I am talking to none other than the Pacific Coast heavyweight champion, the Sheik. Sheik Abdullah Hussein won the belt a couple of weeks ago in Portland, Oregon. Now, you're now looking at the new Pacific Coast heavyweight champion, and congratulations, Mr. Sheik.
Not only did I win the belt a few weeks ago, but I am still undefeated in Iranian death matches. And I still am the master of illusion.
I agree.
No matter what happens, anytime, anywhere, around the world, may it be in Spain or Spokane or Seattle, I am the people's champion. I am the people's choice. Because I am a noble man, I am a rich man, and I am a man that's a member of Oliver's clan.
You're also a man of your word. You said you were going to win the championship, and you did. I have to give you your dues. Now, when are you going to give the former champion?
I'm a man of my word, and I want to show you a little. Just, may I have your assistance there, Mr. Savage? Sir? Just hold on to that silk scarf and watch. Right before your very eyes, I will make a cup right here in my hand before your eyes. I will take this scarf, drape it over my hand, and I will slowly push that scarf down in my hand, finger at a time, a finger at a time. Now, hey, ready to go.
Master of Illusion!
He does that to me every time. How does he do that?
I don't know.
You saw it. You tell me.
Well, I think I saw it.
You were out here telling me last time you saw him do something with it, and tell me where it went. I don't know where it went.
I have no idea, and I was keeping a close watch.
You know, he did the same thing in Seattle. Billy Jack tied him up. Now imagine Billy Jack tying a rope around your wrist.
It's going to be
feature
tight.
That? Yeah. He stood up. He said something after he was tied several times at least several times, and he said something. He looked at Rip Oliver, and he just pulled his arm out of that knot. Just pulled it out. And then he started pummeling Hacksaw Sawyer. He worked on Hacksaw for about 3 or 4 minutes. And I don't know how he did it, but... and then to top it off, Hacksaw had him going, had him beat. And he pulled it out. He won the bout. He won the Iranian Deathmatch. He's also got the title. You've got to give the man his due.
Yeah, you do. He is a man of mystery, that's for sure. He does these things right before your eyes, and you don't even know what you're seeing, really.
Now, I saw him stuff that thing down his hand. That's impossible.
Where did it go? We're getting ready now for the third and final fall, the championship match, the Northwest Tag Team Championship, Billy Jack and Stan Stasiak.
All I have to see him do one of these nights is say he's going to disappear in the ring. If he disappears, I quit wrestling forever. Totally. Man's driving me crazy.
Now, wait a minute. Are you saying that if he doesn't disappear, you're not quitting wrestling?
Well, if he don't disappear, I'll hang around. But if he disappears in the middle of the ring one night, I quit. Billy Jack against Rip Oliver. At least that's what Billy Jack's trying to do. But Stan Stasiak lost that fall. The man that's supposed to be in against Oliver, I think, is Stasiak. No. I'm wrong.
That was the other one.
I'm wrong.
The first one.
This cheek has got me so messed up, I don't know which day it is.
More than that little scarf disappeared, huh?
I'm going to my room and have a stroke. Goodbye.
No, that's Billy Jack in there, all right, but he's in there against the Assassin.
Want to say hello to our British Columbia fans. You'll be seeing us in Stanwood, Washington, along about February, 28th of February. If people want to come down from D.C., we'll have a card in Stanwood. Probably be in Bellingham before then, though.
Oh, Billy Jack.
Billy Jack.
Applying a lot of that muscle, that side headbutt. Oh, the man... The man has a body. What? Oh, I tell you, envy. Envy just sets in, doesn't it, Dutch? When you see a body like that.
I don't know. Billy Jack has so many muscles, like it's unbelievable. The man has muscles where there shouldn't be muscles.
I think you're supposed to be licensed to have those many muscles.
That's what you call locking into a headlock. Assassin's complaining that Billy Jack's grabbing his mask. Uh-oh. Assassin got barred a foul for it.
Oh, well.
Don't make him break the hold. Billy Jack let go, put it right back on. He's got to step back. The assassin doesn't even... Hello.
Now he's going back to the same hold. Assassin tried to whip Billy Jack into the ropes. Billy wasn't going anywhere.
Look at Oliver. Oliver's trying to extort the referee, saying, look, he pulled his mask again.
Well, he's not doing anything to his mask. The assassin was the one that was pulling on his own mask. Billy Jack's trying to plead his case, but it's not going to get him anywhere. And the assassin coming back and feeling the wrath of Billy Jack. Assassin trying to make the tag, and he does with Oliver.
Oliver releases the assassin. Uh-oh, there's a suplex try on Oliver. Billy Jack snapped the headlock on Oliver, and Oliver suplexed him.
Well, that was a
fun. There's going to try for a front. This is a check. I can't. His shoulders are too big. Rolling small
right,
package,
right
giving him some knees.
Well, those are punishing shots with the knee to Billy Jack's throat and neck.
That's the trouble when you're a rookie in this business. These guys that have been around 7 or 8 years know every trick in the book.
There's another one.
Billy's coming along fine, though. One of the strongest young men I've ever seen come into the business. There's a backbreaker by Oliver across the knee. Belly Jack's writhing in pain.
Oh.
He kicked out. He kicked out. That would have busted a normal man's ribcage.
You see the power of that kick out? That was a throw out.
Look at this! Stasiak gets up, kicked Billy Jack into Oliver.
He's got it!
Holy mackerel!
He's got it!
Dan Stasiak, a veteran of 22 years, just threw a draft kick into the back of Billy Jack. Oliver had him up in a slam position. Unbelievable! Ladies and gentlemen,
that's what you call
for
teamwork.
The first time I have seen, I can't even talk, I'm so surprised. You are now looking at the new Pacific Coast Tag Team Champion, a veteran of 23 years in the ring, Stan Stasiak, and a rookie of 1 year, Billy Jack, have just usurped the crown from Rip Oliver and the Assassin. The fans are going crazy.
Oh, they are. That is what you call real teamwork.
Unbelievable. Stasiak drop kicking. That's like saying the Pope isn't Polish, I swear. The Pope will be proud of him because Stan's a Catholic.
They got the belts on now. The Pacific Northwest Tag Team Champions.
Oliver is really hot. Ladies and gentlemen, you've just seen a first here. This is probably one of the youngest men ever to hold one half of the Pacific Coast Heavyweight Tag Team Championship. Billy Jack and Stan Stasiak. Everybody had written Stasiak off. Everybody wrote him off. They said he's been around too long. He's a veteran. He's over the hill.
Look at
well,
that.
There he is. You take a look, my friend. There's a gentleman that's supposed to be over the hill. Stan and Man Stasiak.
The rookie and the veteran. Champion.
What a tag team. The new Pacific. Oliver's still protesting.
Yeah. He's trying to show Sandy Barr exactly what happened. I don't think he really knows even what happened.
Unbelievable. We're going to be talking to Rip Oliver and Ashik up here very shortly about the upcoming card, December the 26th, at the Seattle Center Arena. Sunday, for the first time ever on a Sunday. December 26th, Seattle Center Arena. A steel cage tag team match between a kid you just saw who's half of the championship, Billy Jack. Billy Jack and his partner, Hacksaw Sawyer, for the annual Christmas card. Unbelievable, Don.
Boy, I tell you, be sure and get your tickets for that. I'm going to give you a number to call at 624-4970. Now get your tickets and plan to make that scene at the Seattle Center Arena. The tag team cage match. We got Billy Jack and Hacksaw Sawyer taking on Rip Oliver and the Sheik. We're going to go to Dutch Savage now for a very special interview. Right after this, timeout.
How about something new for a change? Take a look over there. Your new Aurora Chrysler Plymouth dealer has brand new cars, quality cars, and lots of them. A brand new sales staff that really wants your business. Factory trained technicians that want to keep your trust. And brand new management that are ready to meet or beat any car deal in town. Now, isn't that proof that your new Aurora Chrysler Plymouth really wants your business?
Yeah!
Your all new Aurora Chrysler Plymouth, Aurora Avenue North, Seattle.
Troops, I have heard you have been suffering those GI credit blues. You just can't get credit to buy a TV or stereo. Well, stand at ease. Lewis TV and Stereo has name brand TVs and stereos with instant E1 and up financing. They're located close by, too, one block north of Bridgeport on Pacific Highway, and have convenient military hours. Never again will it be as you were. See Lewis TV and Stereo, where credit is never a problem. That is all.
This is a time of light, a time of color, a time when the florists of FTD create their special gifts of the season. The beauty of flowers, the warmth of candles, the classic look of copper. One bouquet perfect as a centerpiece, the other perfect anywhere. The FTD Holiday Glow Bouquets, created with special care for this special time.
Place your order today with Farley's Florist in Tacoma. Saturday.
These girls. I've known they didn't mean anything to you, really. But Gus stole what's happening.
happened to them?
A mad artist stalks the young women of Paris.
You don't like being asked questions?
No.
Got something to hide?
Yes.
Why must you continue to throw them into the Seine for the police to find?
John Carradine stars as the notorious Bluebeard. Saturday's Owl Theater at 11 on Q13.
Ladies and gentlemen, coming up to the Crow's Nest now after just losing the title to Stasiak and Billy Jack, Rip Oliver.
A mighty misjustice. Everybody's seen what just happened. Everybody's seen it, what happened. Sandy Barr seen it himself. They stole our belts. Okay, we'll get our belts back. Now, I'm getting down to one thing. I suckered this little Pack Sawyer and Billy Jack, the Sheik, and myself, got them right where we want them, right in the Seattle Center Arena, in a cage, a 10-foot cage all the way around the ring. There's nothing more I could ask for Christmas than to get these two boys in there and make my dream come true. We've got them, tell them, baby.
You know something, Sawyer? You had that musclehead Billy Jack tie my wrist to the top turnbuckle, and he tied it with every strength he had in his body. But with a little illusion, I slipped right out. And I attacked you and beat you like the dog you are. And believe you me, don't be surprised if you turn around and see Oliver and I standing outside that cage after they lock us in it, and we're outside looking in at you animals. Because we're not animals. We don't belong in a cage. But we're going to stay in that cage just long enough. Just long enough. That's right. Turn your dial up. I want you to hear what I'm telling you, people. To come there, it's the last night that you'll ever see Sawyer and you'll ever see Billy Jack, because their career is ended. They'll have to unlock the cage to get them out, and Oliver and I will just kind of mystically walk through.
Haven't you heard it? We finally got it right in the cage in the Seattle Center Arena on the 26th. I saw your... Brother, I've been waiting a long, long time. Billy Jack, after the slick one you just pulled on me, brother, you're going to pay. You got some dues to pay, baby.
Well, you heard what the man said. This is going to be not just a tag team cage match. It's going to be a grudge match.
Boy, there's going to be something else. They're going to be locked in by the commission. The gate will be locked, and then all hand is going to break loose. No, there's no regulations. There's nothing in there. Just the referee to raise the winner's hand. If you don't like blood, it's going to be a real gory thing. You people in Montesano, we'll be seeing you on the 9th, on the 16th over in Tacoma, and Yakima on the 17th, Finley, Washington on the 23rd, Banks, Oregon the 24th. The list goes on, and we're going to be real busy starting the new year, Don.
We certainly are, and we certainly invite you to come on out and catch professional wrestling when it comes to your area. And thank you for joining us this afternoon for Big Time Wrestling. This is Don Cross along with Doug Savage.
Good night, Kate.
So long. See you next week. This has been Big Time Wrestling, the very best.